Yeah, the company was called Keyhole, and we were a startup that was founded in 2001, and we were acquired by Google in 2004.
And it's a great idea to map everything.
So there's different aspects to this. When we started Keyhole, I think the big hook was that we had this very good 3D visualization of satellite imagery, and nobody had ever seen that before. So when I saw that, I knew that we wanted to do it, and we spent several years making that come true. When it came to mapping, this was more after we joined Google and decided that we're going to map all the countries in the world. We originally licensed data from Tiles and Navtech to do that, but now we have MapMaker allowing users to create maps of countries that nobody has covered before, like Philippines and Vietnam, Pakistan, and so on.
How does it feel to be a grad and hear you guys come back
I had a great time at Lawrence High and at KU, and I wanted to be able to bring some of that back. I think Silicon Valley is a great place to develop hardware and software, and I'd like to introduce the engineers of KU to that.
You were talking about the future, all the futures, most of which I didn't understand. Is television, as I know, since I work for TV, I'm part of Scripps Howard Stations, and I get the feeling that they feel that television is on its way out. You obviously know much more about that than I do. Is television dead?
I think that it, in the darkest terms, it's dying. But I think it's a long time going, because the people who are familiar with it will stay with it, and expect to see broadcast television, for the rest of their lives. And so, the newer, younger generation has already jumped off. They are watching videos on their iPod and on their phone, and using TiVo to, pick off the things that they want to watch. And I think that television will end up being a la carte event, where people choose to watch the segments they're interested in. And if you have a good news segment and people want to watch the news, then you'll get a big audience, but it'll be a different one than you have today, where people just flip to a channel and watch it every day. It's because you found your audience and held it.
Does it seem like we're going backwards? We just got, everybody is on high def, and technology, everything is getting, much clearer, but everybody's looking at it on these tiny screens. What's wrong?
Yes, I think that is an issue. The screens are getting better. The most recent Android phone is 840 by 480, which is about quarter HD, which is better than regular television and TSC was. So I think things are getting better on the phone, but they're still very small. But I also think the big televisions are getting cheaper, and that you're going to see people wanting to watch the cinematic shows and the high-resolution news footage on the big screens, as they become more prevalent, it'll really be more that the phone is how I choose what to watch, but I'll watch it on the bigger screens.
And last question, everybody has heard of Google. Is Google going to take over the world?
It's a very competitive place, and I believe that there are many companies out there who are doing interesting things. As I told the audience here, I think that the biggest apps haven't been invented yet, and I think one of Google's goals is to help build the technologies that people use to do that. But I don't think that we're going to solve the world's problems, and I think there'll be a lot of opportunity for everybody else to, come after us and either work with us or compete with us.